14th Street by German Teletubbies. The other question is, even real? If so, why? Let's hear what the people have to say about that.
Yes, I believe evil is real because according to what's written in the scriptures, Jesus Christ himself encountered a number of persons who were demon-possessed. And even within our own community, we have various incidents which were associated with evil. And people talk about doing people things, evil things, sometimes to appease themselves because they want to show where they have the evil power. Other times it's to take revenge on someone. So I believe that evil is real.
Yes, evil exists because God says so. And God who created all things, evil exists. I create both evil and evil. So I believe it exists because God says so.
I not believe in evil, because Satan is real. All the thing that happened in the earth today is Satan, and it's real.
There is good and there is evil. Because that's why one of the bad angels was cast out of the holy heaven's place. Alright? And basically, from the terminology of what we have read, where the book that I read show me that good and evil. Alright? So basically right now, they say we were born in sin and raised in iniquity. So therefore, we don't know who's going to take the good side and who's going to take the bad side. So your mind may play wonders on you. You might have a good side of mind and you might have a bad side of mind. But just try to find the good in it and do the good that you should and make everybody be prosperous. Right? As I said before, learning is better than silver or gold. But silver or gold will vanish away, but a good education will never decay.
Evil in this world is real. Everyday evil, people is doing evil. And in this life is not about it's all about spirit. Spirit that controls the world.
A question was asked me earlier saying whether I believe evil exists. And the most appropriate person to answer this question is Christ himself. He says in Matthew 5:11, "Blessed are he when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for so persecuted did the prophets which were before you." He also says in Matthew 5:47, "But let your communication be yea, yea, or nay, nay. For whatsoever is more than these cometh of evil." I would like to let you know that evil is not only perfectly portrayed in a being called Satan, but is able to pass on its characteristics to us through obedience to him. Evil to God is not just simply the act of playing with potions and mixtures and ointments and rubs and scrubs. It is out of the abundance of the heart, the mind, seat of intelligence. What lies in there is either can be for good or for destruction, which is evil. God is saying to us, evil can be said about us, and we ourselves can communicate evil through our conversations. But knowing what God requires is obedience, which leads to him being satisfied with us, which is called perfection. I encourage you to submit yourselves unto God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. And Christ, who dwells in you, would bring forth the good works of righteousness, holiness, and truth. St. Lucia, turn to God, for this is the only way in which evil can be placed out of the heart and righteousness take over.
You heard what the people have to say? They said it in no uncertain terms how they see evil. To my, we are on Coral Street, and to the extreme of my back is the old Supreme Court of St. Lucia. Having said this, I now take you back to the studio.